How not to handle exceptions. Part one. So I have my procedure called my procedure. It runs a bunch of code, and for some reason along the way, it raises an exception. And what I've done is put the following exception handler in my code. Exception, when others, in other words, catch any exception, then null, do nothing. I compile my procedure. Looks good. I run my procedure. Looks good. But wait a minute, is that good? So it's successfully completed, which might make you feel pretty good, but in fact my program failed, and I don't even notice that it failed, and the reason is that I have swallowed up or hidden each and every possible exception that might get raised. In general, this is a really bad idea. If an exception occurs, you want to know about it, you want to let your users know about it, and the information that you give to yourself versus your users might be quite different, but in any case, it's really dangerous to swallow up or hide exceptions. Now, sure, sometimes you might actually not want to allow an exception to propagate out and cause a failure in the outer block. For example, suppose I have a procedure that creates a table for me dynamically, execute dynamic DDL. This is a dangerous and interesting thing to do, so I'm not saying you should go ahead and create tables dynamically, but if you happen to do it, you might say, well, if the table already exists, in other words, if I get a negative 955 error, that's okay. It's already in place. I don't need to create it. Otherwise, I'm going to raise the exception back out, propagate the exception out unhandled. So I create this procedure. When I try to create a new table that has a bad name, I see an exception. When I try to create a table with a name that already exists, oh, nothing happened. So that might be the behavior you want, and I have a special trapping of the exception I want to ignore, but even in these cases, you generally won't want to just say null. You'll probably want to write a message out to your log table saying, this was attempted, it didn't happen, it might be okay, but at least now you know. How not to handle an exception. Take two. I've got my procedure. I run some code. Something goes wrong, an exception is raised. Now I trap the exception. I don't say null. I don't want to just hide the exception. I say raise, propagate the exception back out to the enclosing program. I compile my program. Yay! I run my program. It fails, and I see that it failed with program error. So, what's wrong with this? Well, the problem with this exception section is that it doesn't add any value. There's no reason to handle the exception, simply to re-raise it. In other words, it's exactly the same as this. I get the same failure information. But now, when I see the line number, it takes me all the way back to the line number where the error was actually raised. If I trap and then re-raise the exception, it only brings it back to the line number on which the error was re-raised. So, again, in general, don't include an exception section that doesn't add value. All it does is re-raise the exception. How not to handle exceptions, take three. So, my procedure runs in a bunch of code, raises an exception. In my exception section, I trap any error, and I display a message. So I don't just say null, I don't care, ignore. Now I'm not ignoring it. I'm displaying a message telling me that the program failed. I run my program. Well, I'll compile my program. I run my program. Hooray! I see that my program failed. So good. This is better than before, right? Well, maybe just a little bit, but not very much. There are several problems with taking this approach. First of all, I did not re-raise my exception. So once again, I did swallow up the exception from the standpoint of allowing my programs to continue executing as if nothing went wrong. That's bad. Second of all, I displayed a message with dbmsoutput.putline. That's going to be almost no use in a production environment in which I have no access to the dbmsoutput output buffer. I will not see this information. Third problem, what information did I get? All I know is that my program failed. I don't know what the problem is. I don't know what might have caused it. I don't know what the current state of my application was when it happened. I just know that it failed. Not very helpful. How not to handle an exception. Take four. Well, okay, so just saying program failed is not very good. How about if I display a message and I pass in the error message for display? Run my code, compile my code, run my code, and now the DB miss output tells me that I had a program error. Well, that's better than before, and we could even display more information, but it's still not good enough because we're just displaying it to the output buffer. We're not saving it for analysis later, and there's a lot more information I'd like to get than just the error message. For example, I'd like to know the line on which my error occurred. So let's sum up on how not to handle exceptions. Part one, don't swallow up or hide errors. So if you're going to handle an exception, then make sure you log the information and then re-raise it back out so the enclosing block knows that something went wrong. Don't simply display the error code on the screen using dbmissoutput.putline. In production, you are very unlikely to be able to see that information. Finally, don't handle and re-raise the exception without adding value. To say when others then raise semicolon doesn't do anything for you except disrupt the backtrace and you lose the original line number on which the error was raised. So, check out my How Not to Handle Exceptions Part 2 to see more examples of bad exception handling, and then finally check out How to Handle Exceptions Properly.